Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Speed Shapinator 3 channel here, and welcome to my Formula One My Team JPO Career Mode, and episode number 24 of my My Team JPO Career Mode. If you missed the previous one, which was the Australian Grand Prix in our second season opener, be sure to check it out on youtube.com/speedshapinator3. And if there's any new subscribers out there, boys and girls, male and female, be sure to click on the red bell and subscribe to my channel and enjoy my magnificent show of the Speed Shapinator 3 channel. Well, after a previous Australian race, it was a very crashy, eventful Australian race after Lewis Hamilton got aggression, but let's hope the aggression will calm down in this episode of 24 of my Formula One 19 JPO Career Mode at the Bahrain Grand Prix at the Dakar International Circuit for our first night race of the season. And then last season we finished 12th here after wing damage in our car. But let's see if we can provide better results this season for full results here at the Dakar International Circuit. We have done very well here in practice. Our medium tires, we were P5, and then we were the fastest in practice session 2 and 3. So we have done a very good job here, and there's no sign of rain here at the Bahrain Grand Prix, because Bahrain is located in the Persian Gulf, so we won't have to worry about any rain. This will be full stream and full speed of racing here at the Dakar International Circuit. Let's see if we can try to get our third pole in our career in qualifying for the Bahrain Grand Prix. Here we go, episode number 24. In the previous race, I finished on podium finish after having a big smackdown fight with Lewis Hamilton, but let's hope his aggression will be eliminated for this event. And then my teammate Sergio Perez finished in the top 10, so let's hope we continue to make more points and continue to boost our car up a little bit for a top 10 finish. And I got a new sponsor, Echo, and let's see if this time we can get some points, constructive points out of here and come away with a good win, or maybe a top 3 finish or whatever we go to. So here we go, we're getting ready to qualify for this race. Let's see what the fastest lap will be. We already cracked in a minute 28. Cracked in the minute 29 mark. Everybody else is a minute 29, but now we're gonna have to go up to a minute 28 and be a little bit more faster. And my teammate Sergio Perez does a good job. See how we do here at the Bahrain Grand Prix. First night race of the season. Let's see if we can provide more fun and more results and not make any more mistakes out there. I'm tired of making the mistakes of flashbacks. If you also missed the NASCAR E5 that I uploaded last night, you can also check that out on youtube.com/speedshapinator3. That was episode number 5 at Atlanta Motor Speedway. This weekend, realized when I started racing at my old hometown of New England, about New Hampshire. P5 right now in the first qualifying session. So it's a minute 28.337, but Max Verstappen is the fastest right now. And the Mercedes are getting a bit slow with 34 passes. So me and P5 and Sergio Perez barely gets into P10, but we already automatically go up into second qualifying session. And Lando Norris was the last car that made it, but look at this, Williams, Bottas cars and the Alfa Romeo cars have been knocked out of qualifying number one. So P5 is not bad, but let's see if we can try to get it up there. Let's see how we can do now in the second qualifying session. Well, Sergio Perez does qualify in the minute 28 mark, but he's dropping down a little bit. Than minute 26 or minute 27. We have to get the car better. We have to stop hitting the apron, and already Lewis Hamilton and Valtteri Bottas have cracked in a minute 27. Oh my goodness, and Lando Norris just knocked out Sergio Perez for P10. So Sergio Perez has been knocked out of qualifying. We're still in P6, but we can crack in a minute 27 if we try to not hit the aprons too much. Right now is a minute 27.968. 23. That was a magnificent qualifying right there. Minute 28.062. Let's see if it's going to stand. And I think it did. I think indeed it will stand. And we are going to start P3 here at the Bahrain Grand Prix.
Hamilton, Leclerc, and Hawke. Goodbye for now then, but we're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
And that's a pretty adversarial position that I went into. And now we're going to start in P3 here at the Bahrain Grand Prix. And I beat out Botas in the qualifying lap. I took a second lap in there, and it paid off. And a P3, I like that. That means I could get around Leclerc and Hamilton for the lead without any trouble. And Daniel Ricciardo starts in 7th, Albon, and remember, Perez will be starting in P11. So let's see how we can do, and let's hope that Perez will get a top 10, so that way we can get points out of that constructive point standing. What a great job in qualifying. And that final qualifying lap, I just needed a little bit of a speed out of the car, and that gave me enough to give me P3. What an incredible job right there. And starting on the inside of row 2, and I'm going to be right behind Leclerc and the leader, Lewis Hamilton.
Chance in the race.
Well, let's hope we have a great chance in the race, and let's hope Sergio Perez can make it into the top 10. And the weather will be clear as usual here at the Bahrain International Circuit. So let's get ready for episode number 24, and let's see if we can just try to beat out Valtteri Bottas within 5 races remaining so we can get more claim boosts out of our point system and everything else. And this is going to be 57 laps here at the Bahrain Sakhar International Circuit here for our first night race of the season. We finished 12 last season, but let's see if we can come through flying colors this time with either a win or a podium. So here we go. Episode number 24 of my Formula One My Team JPO Career Mode. Let's get racing at night at Bahrain prime time.
Stage is set for another enthralling race here in the Kingdom of Bahrain, a Ferrari stronghold in years gone by, but will they be able to add to their record today? There's no shortage of passing opportunities around the 3.36 miles of the Bahrain International Circuit, with the best at Turn 1, of course, and then another soon into Turn 4. 15 corners here, 6 to the left and 9 to the right. And we could see one or two flat spots into the tight left-hander of Turn 10. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Anthony, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are 3 main things to worry about there, Crossy. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and it's Charles Leclerc in P2. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Fork, Bottas, Sebastian Vettel, and Verstappen, Ricciardo, Albon, Norris, and Carlos Sainz, Perez, Fiat, George Russell, and Gasly, Ocon, Stroll, Kimi Raikkonen, and Roman Grosjean, Giovinazzi, Magnussen, De Vries, and Nicholas Latifi. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
Points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish.
So we're starting in P3 next to Charles Leclerc and Lewis Hamilton. Let's see if we can get a good restart and pass both of them so we can take the lead and then maybe try to dominate this race. But let's hope the engine and the car will be reliable. We spend less laps during practice and then qualifying, and let's see if we can do well. And then we're going to start off with the soft tires, but if they strategize with the soft tires as well, we'll also do that. We'll do that simultaneously, and then go with the mediums the rest of the way. Let's take a look at our race direction. See what everybody's going to go for. Yeah, they're all going to go for soft tires. Yeah, each and every one of those drivers are going to go for soft tires. So we're just making sure that they are, because the last time we went here in the Bahrain Grand Prix, we saw some of them going to medium tires and everything, and it ruined their strategy just a little bit. And we're going to take maybe 60 laps of fuel, so that way we could go into rich mix and then try to pull away from Hamilton and Leclerc. So here we go. Let's get ready for our formation lap to roll away for and start to begin episode number 24 in the Bahrain Grand Prix. Here we go. And during that Yeah, doesn't continue.
The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights.
All right, the firing lights are going to come on very shortly to get this Bahrain Grand Prix all set for the first night race of the season. Oh, we got a yellow. Looks like somebody has broken down over there. First retirement of the race. After 15 to 57, we see somebody broke down, and it's George Russell and Williams. He is out of the race. So one of our back marker teams is out of the running. George Russell gets a DNF.
Okay, the gap behind is 3.4 seconds.
Eric is the only driver that can hold the game. fastest. Thank you. out of contention and not winning the Bahrain Grand Prix.
Thank you. Sergio is in the pits.
154.6.
Thank you. job out here. I had a great race today. No mistake, no contact or anything.
Thank you.
fuel remaining.
Oh no, that's unavoidable contact. He spun me out. Man, in the final lap of the race, he spun me out. Use a flashback. Now I spun around, yes.
Green flag.
Take that out. right on that border. Liam, respect that on me again. For the second race in a row. And I'm going to win the Bahrain Grand Prix. I know it wasn't pretty, but I got the win anyway. And I got a
fantastic drive.
Career victory.
Fantastic. You deserve that race win.
Man, this was a last lap mayhem in the final lap between me and Hamilton. And he smacked me down again. I'm only going to say one flashback because the 2-1 is one of the contest because he spun me out completely.
Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such
incredible
results?
Well, Hamilton was out of the camp, but I said not this time, not like he did in Australia.
They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs.
Man, I had a great car.
It's a
dominating car.
The faces on our top three look so incredibly happy as they make their way up to the podium. A much-deserved victory and a brilliant performance from them all.
Well, I think Hamilton is still celebrating, but we peeped it out and everything, but... I don't know what happened. It was a last lap mayhem here at the race. It was an incredible, and they gave me such an incredible car. And I know it was slow at the end, but they're going to work on that and everything. And then,
in the driver's table. Not the results our points leader wanted, but it certainly makes things interesting going forward. Some amazing talents out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Difficult call, but I'd like to say Esteban Ocon. He's just so gifted at getting the most out of his tyres, and he showed that today.
It's time to check out the constructor standing. Mercedes moves to the top of the table. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time. Be sure to join us again as we continue to bring you the latest excitement in Formula One.
Well, what an exciting race it was here at the Bahrain Grand Prix, and I totally dominated the whole race and everything. Had a good car and all that, but then I was a little bit unstable right at the end, and then the last lap mayhem, and Hamilton was at it again, and trying to beat me up again, and then, and he spun me out once. I had to use a flashback on that, and then out of this whole entire race, Hamilton was at it again, and then we were making slingshot moves leading the race. And everything, and then in the final lap of the race, then he spun me out. And then the second time, then he nudged me a little bit, another unavoidable contact. And then the third time, I got him. The third time was a charm right there. And I do apologize. I know the YouTube, I'm going to see that last lap mayhem. But, I'm glad that I didn't use all my flashbacks and everything. If I'd used them all, I would have lost this race and all this. But I wanted to win this race bad and then give the team a plenty of boost so that way we could get our R&D developments for the next race in the Vietnam Grand Prix. Here's how the standing is, and I'm only just two behind Max Verstappen. Lewis Hamilton is third, Bottas, and then Sainz going fourth and fifth. Perez is still running at ninth. But I don't think we're going to get any points because I have that new sponsor, Echo, and he should have made some points. And I still stay in third, but I'm getting edging closer to going to second over Red Bull Racing. But great racing here at the Bahrain Grand Prix, and I totally have a dominant car. But there's a sign of things to come, and let's hope Perez improves a little bit for the next race. Let's take a look at the highlights. We got to see at the end of the race. angle of our pit stop. So in the second year, I went Bahrain, and I came through with flying colors, but instead, this is part two. Look at the pass that Lewis Hamilton was doing. Mayhem, that's what we're going to call it here in our episode number 24 of my career mode. Congratulations to the win and everything, and it took me, and I didn't have to use any of the flashbacks this entire race until the last lap, and to getting the win, it was great, and it was a SmackDown part two for Lewis Hamilton.
Great work out there today. Let's have your thoughts. What do you think made the difference between this weekend and last weekend?
Well, Rich's focus with durability really paid off and everything. But what a great job of the team and all that. They did so great.
Your team must be ecstatic with how you're performing. Great. Well, that's everything.
Well, thank you very much, Claire. That was a short interview right there. It could have been longer than that after that win. Well, let's see how much money we can invest. I know we're not going to make any because Sergio Perez did not finish where he was supposed to be. So let's hope he can do it good in the Vietnam Grand Prix. We didn't score 33 points. We only got 25 points. So we only get about 9.3 million. We should have, Perez should have done well in the Bahrain Grand Prix. He had the car and everything. He was running as high as fifth, but then looks like his car was doing pretty much the same thing I was doing. But I think with those R&D developments for the next race in Vietnam, that it's really going to have a more boost of power. Well, we're going to change cars and everything for our headquarters for the next race, to prepare for the next race in the Vietnam Grand Prix.
From the
oh man, the fuser failed. And we got a failed upgrade. It was the diffuser. And we said we were going to do a chassis upgrade. And we don't have enough points yet to get that piston upgrade. Two chassis upgrades coming up, and then the diffuser. And I don't know why that thing failed. And we're up to 9.3 million. All right, we did all four of our upgrades and everything, but with the build time, I got to do. The next one. start off with the fitness center. Yeah, we're going to have to put the analysis booth, and we can do that. That'll give us plenty of booths. So what are we going to do with the personnel thing? And that will leave us a pretty good amount of money right there. And we do have our weekly resource coming up for the next month of the Vietnam Grand Prix. And we're going to change cars and everything. So that's going to wrap it up here for the Bahrain Grand Prix. And thank you so much for watching. And it was a last lap mayhem finish between me and Hamilton. And he was at it again. And I had to use the flashback. And all of the flashbacks in the last two races have been by him. So I hope everyone has a good day, and thank you so much for watching. It was pretty boring throughout the race, but then at the end, it was much more exciting. But thank you very much, everyone, for watching my Formula One 2020, my Team JPO Career Mode, the Bahrain Grand Prix, and we'll see you in the next one in the Vietnam Grand Prix for episode number 25. Everyone, stay healthy, be safe, and have a good day, and enjoy the rest of your night. So long, everyone.